If you want to be outstanding in the field, you have to be outstanding in the field. And that's really what this class is all about. It's like every single week we are outdoors, we are collecting measurements, we are analyzing the data that the students collected, which means it's going to be messy, it's not going to have clean answers, it's going to be complicated. And the class is really about like, what do you do when the real world is messy? How do you still come up with answers to the questions that you have, even when you have a high level of uncertainty? And like, how do you navigate through that uncertainty? Geomorphology is a really big subtopic within geology, right? It's like processes that happen near the Earth's surface as opposed to like deep below the surface. And so this class really focuses on surface water. So it's kind of taking the water cycle and then zooming in on all of the different parts of the water cycle and learning in depth about how those processes work. How have humans interfered? How can we try to participate in the water cycle in a non-destructive way in the future? It's amazing that we have a large river and a small creek both flowing through campus. And so students can see how a river behaves and how a stream behaves, how they're different, how they interact with each other. Our second week lab is stream gauging in Spring Creek, which flows right through campus. It's like a really small creek, and that makes it challenging to measure things. There's not that much water. And so the goal for that lab is for the students to figure out how much water is flowing in this creek. We pour a known amount of salt and fluorescent dye into the creek. And I have the students calculate ahead of time how much salt will be enough to be detectable with their instruments, but not so much that it will harm the aquatic life in the creek. I dump it in, and then the students are measuring the salt concentration over time, and they can use that to calculate the flow rate in the creek. The next week, third week, our lab is mapping the stream channel features of the Cannon River. And the purpose of that is learning how to make a channel morphology map. And the reason we do it by canoe is that I think it's much more valuable as a learning experience to be on the river moving with the water at the speed of the water. And if you keep getting stuck on gravel bars, you're eventually gonna learn like, oh, the gravel bars tend to happen in this part of the stream channel. We're gonna avoid them now. It takes all these abstract concepts that we've talked about in the classroom and makes them really concrete. It's eighth week. This is my favorite lab we do all term. It's late in the term. And so it's kind of the culmination of everything else we've done. We're going to this creek. It's called Trout Brook. It's the trout stream in Minnesota that has one of the highest nitrate contamination problems in the state. And so the overarching question of the lab is, where is the nitrate coming from? It's kind of this like integrative project where we're trying to pull together all these different pieces that we learned about over the course of the term and answer a really applied question, right? It's like, where's this contamination coming from? Once you know where it is, you can hopefully figure out what to do about it. Geomorphology is a really field-based class, and so I think one of the things I also really aim for is for students to appreciate, like, Minnesota's beautiful. Like, these places are beautiful. Nobody's gonna take care of them if they don't see them in the first place. So it's a lot of just like getting people outside and being like, wow, like yes, the Cannon River is worth taking care of. Spring Creek is worth taking care of. Like, we do have the ability to do things that are gonna have positive impacts on these places. And we hope that that builds up the confidence and skills to then tackle these like big global problems.